Now, in this lecture, we will discuss about addition of carbene to 6-2-butene. So, let us say we have 6-2-butene. And we have to add carbene. Carbene is CH2 double dot. Now we are interested in what will be the product in this case. To discuss further, we must know there are two kinds of carbene. One carbene in which these two electrons are paired. So we have lone pair of electrons. That is, electron is paired. And this carbene is called singlet carbene. We have another kind of carbene in which electrons are not paired. This kind of carbene is called triplet carbene. Now, singlet carbene, carbon is sp2 hybridized. In case of triplet carbene, carbon is sp hybridized. If you see the orbital picture diagram of singlet carbene, we will have carbon hydrogen one bond here. We will have carbon hydrogen bond and we will have a lone pair of electron here and one p lobe is empty. Carbene act as electrophile, so these are electron deficient molecules. So if you see carbene, we have 2, 4, 6 electron, here also we have 2, 4, 6 electron. So carbene is electron deficient molecule. So it acts as an electrophile. So this is singlet carbene. We have triplet carbene sp hybridized, so we have one carbon hydrogen bond. This orbital has electrons also, so each bonded orbital has 2 electron. This also has 2 electron. This is another sp lobe. Here we have hydrogen. Now we have 2 p lobe. One p lobe has 1 electron. And another p lobe that is perpendicular to this p lobe. This also has 1 electron. So we can say in this case, if this is px, then this is py. So px py has 1 electron. This is your triplet carbene. Now first we'll discuss addition of singlet carbene. So we have 6-2-butene. And we add singlet carbene. Now when we are adding singlet carbene, we have two possibility. Basically CH2 can add from top face of alkene or it can add from bottom face of alkene. If you see the orbital picture of alkene, so alkene has pi electron on top, it also has pi electron on bottom. Now CH2 has a sp2 lobe that has 2 electron. Now this sp2 lobe can overlap either from top face or it can overlap from bottom face. So there are two possibilities. CH2 can insert, basically this is CH2 insertion reaction. So in this reaction methylene gets inserted, CH2 double dot gets inserted. So insertion can be possible. From top as well as bottom face of alkene. So let us say if I add from top, so top insertion. What we will have? If I am adding CH2 from top, that is we are making a bond between this carbon and this carbon. So this group will go slightly down and this group will go slightly down. This hydrogen and methyl will go slightly down. So now we will have a CH2 is inserted between these two carbon and this hydrogen will go slightly down and this methyl will also go slightly down. Here is also the same, so we will have hydrogen is going slightly down and methyl is also going down. Now same molecule we can show in a better way. So this is CH2, here we have one group is downside, one group is front side. So on dashed line we have hydrogen, on solid line we have methyl. Now if I want to write this molecule, so let us say if I rotate this molecule by 90 degrees, so that this plane of ring goes away from the observer. So plane of ring goes away from the observer. So we will have this methyl will come up and hydrogen will be down. Similarly here methyl is up, hydrogen is down. So let us call this compound is 1. Now what will happen, that is from bottom face insertion. So now this time we have bottom face insertion. And this is a case of singlet carbene. So if I add CH2 from bottom face, so we'll have a bond between this carbon and this carbon and this carbon and this carbon. So we are going to make a bond here and here. So this group will go slightly up, lifted up because of a steric repulsion. So we have something like this. Methyl is on solid line. Same thing we can write. Let us say if I write something like this, hydrogen is inside and methyl is upside. Here also hydrogen is inside and we have methyl is upside. Now if I rotate this molecule so that this plane comes towards the observer, So we are rotating through 90 degree and the plane of ring is towards the observer. So we can see the same molecule something like this. Methyl will go on top, hydrogen will go on bottom. Let us call this compound as 2. Now if you see compound 1 and 2, compound 1 is this. Compound 2 is this. So this is 1, this is 2. It looks like that there are two enantiomers, but basically these are two not enantiomers. These two, 1 and 2, are mirror images. We have methyl, 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 hydrogen, hydrogen. So these two are 1 and 2 are mirror images. But these two mirror images are superimposable. So let us say we have 2 methyl hydrogen, methyl hydrogen. Let us rotate this molecule about this axis, axis passing through methyl hydrogen bond, and we are rotating through 180 degree. So if I will rotate through 180 degree, so this axis is basically will remain same. Now this ring is front side, now it will go back side. Anything, any carbon will be rotated by 180, so this will go diametrically opposite, so it will be somewhere here. That is, ring will be now inside. Now this carbon will come here. We will have methyl and hydrogen, and this is same as 1. So we can say 1 and 2 are same. So we have either cis 2-butene addition from top or addition from bottom, we have same product. And this product is basically meso. If you see, this has a plane of symmetry. If I cut this molecule from this plane, molecule is symmetrical, so molecule has a plane of symmetry. So this is meso. So now we can say if I have cis-2-butene and if we add carbene, that is sp2 singlet carbene, we will have only one product, and in this case product is meso. Now if I add triplet carbene, so we discussed case of singlet carbene. Now if you see, triplet carbene is sp hybridized, it has two lone electrons. So let us discuss case B, that is addition of triplet carbene. Now in this case we have two electrons, that is unpaired. Now in this case we have addition follow radical mechanism. So addition follows radical mechanism. That is, now one of the electron from here and one of the electron from here forms a bond. And here we have CH2. This group will be slightly up because this becomes sp3 hybridized and it will have one electron. So it will look something like this. Now it has one electron. Now this CH2 electron can couple with this one. Now there are two possibilities. It can directly form a bond. In this case we will have hydrogen, methyl, and we will have CH2. Hydrogen will be inside and methyl will be outside. Another possibility is this bond is formed after rotation. So if this bond rotates about 180 degree, we will have methyl inside and hydrogen outside. It has one electron. Now this can add, so it will form methyl hydrogen CH2. So we have two products. This is one product before rotation, before sigma bond rotation. And this product we have, that is after rotation. Now if I rotate this molecule through an axis passing through carbon and carbon by 90 degree, presently this carbon and this carbon, that is ring, in the plane of paper. So this ring is in the plane of paper. If I rotate by 90 degree, this ring will come away from the plane of paper. So it will look something like, so this ring is away. So this means to ask the observer. Now this methyl will go down and hydrogen will go up. Similarly here, hydrogen will go down and methyl will go up. Now if I perform the same operation for this molecule, rotate by 90 degree, so this ring will come out of the plane, that is towards the observer. Here we have hydrogen will go down and methyl be up. Hydrogen is down, methyl is up. If you see, this molecule is cis and this molecule methyl is opposite, so this is trans. So if I have triplet carbene, we are getting cis and trans isomer. We can summarize, if I have cis 2-butene and if I add singlet carbene, that is CH2 dot, in this case we are getting only one product and that is not optically active, that is meso. Now if I have cis-2-butene, we have triplet carbene. Now in this case we will have two product and these two products are geometrical isomers, that is cis and trans. one is cis, another is trans. So in this lecture we discuss addition of singlet carbene, that is syn addition, is a stereospecific that gives only one isomer, but addition of triplet carbene is not a stereospecific. It gives both product cis as well as trans. In this case we have rotation about the single bond, that is the main reason to give two products. So rotation about single bond.